Okay, third time's a charm. Andrew here. This is a video about how to run the remote sound system in the cafe.
So let's go take a look at the remote sound system and just see what the components are. We've got an auxiliary output for iPads, iPhones, etc. We've got a Furman power conditioner. It's basically a fancy, let's turn on a flash here. It's a fancy power strip. It's got one in the front, the rest are in the back and connected to other things. We've got the wireless mic receiver. Let me turn that off. And we've got this little control here that determines what I'm talking to. It can be set to narthex, which means I'm controlling the sound of the cafe, none, which means I'm controlling nothing, or full, which means I'm controlling the sanctuary and the cafe. I've got this mixer here. It's got a tape player on it, which we'll never use, a CD player, and then it actually mixes here one, which is the mic input, tape, CD, and auxiliary. And then we have here the juice goose. It's basically this key that I can turn on and off the system with, and I'll turn it off for later. And there's a drawer here, and the drawer has the mic in it. It has the TV remote for that TV there, or the TV over there. It also works on the TVs in the sanctuary. And there's also an instruction sheet in here, which is what we used before this video. So those are the components of the system. Now let's look at operation of the system. You're gonna wanna know how to turn everything on, how to turn everything off, how to use a mic, how to use the CD player, and how to use the auxiliary input for an iPad or your phone or an MP3 player. So the first thing we're gonna look at is how to turn the system on. So before we go any further, a little bit of theory. When you turn on a powerful sound system like the church's system, you want to turn things on as far away from the speakers first, and then work your way towards the speakers. And when you turn it off, you want to turn things off as close to the speakers, and then work your way away from the speakers. So let's say these are the speakers over here. The next thing is the amplifiers that drive the speakers. Then you've got the mixer that sends sound to the amplifiers. And then you have your sound sources that get plugged into the mixer, like the wireless mic receiver. So when you turn things on, you want to turn on the wireless mic receiver first, then the mixer, and then the amps that drive the speakers. And then when you turn everything off, you want to do things in reverse order. So you turn off the amps, then the mixer, and then the wireless mic receiver. So here's how that's done. Here's the wireless mic receiver, turn that on. Here's the mixer, turn that on. Oops, it was already on. And then you turn on the amplifiers, the juice goose. Once this light turns on up at the top, it's done turning all of them on upstairs. Wait for it, and done.
And now, how to turn it off, the reverse order.
First, you turn off the juice goose, and it's very important that you wait now, because if you were to turn this off immediately, the amps would still be on and it would make a pop. So wait for it, now it's off. Now you can turn off the mixer and you can turn off the wireless mic receiver.
So now let's take a look at how you use the mic. And the first thing we're gonna look at is how you turn on the mic and check the battery level to see if you need to put new AA batteries in it.
So we get out the mic from the drawer and then we hold down the button at the bottom of the mic until the red light comes on, which I can't see, where is it? There, the red light's on. So it's on, and then you can look at this little window, oops, it's upside down. And you might not be able to see it on the video, but there's four little bars that show you the battery level. If you have less than four, it's no good. If you can't see it here, you can always look at it here on the receiver. It will show you the battery strength of the mic it's connected to once it gets connected to it. There we go. So just wait a little bit. If you have four bars, you're good. If you have anything less than that, you should replace the batteries. There's also a level meter here. I'll talk into the mic and you can see that it's receiving signal. Okay, but it's not making any sound. So what do we do next? The first thing we do, well, we got to turn the sound on. So hold just a second. Okay, so I turned everything on. So now we can go over here. And if I want to choose just the sound in the cafe, I go to Narthex. If I want to do the cafe and the sanctuary, I do full. I'm just going to do Narthex. Let me press menu to lock it in. Ooh, and it was loud. So I turned it down on number one. And I can turn it up again. And now I'm in the speakers. Remember, we keep volume all the way up. That's the best sound quality.
Once I have the volume set where I want it, I can just turn off the mic when I want to mute things, basically, and turn it back on when I want to talk again, once you have the level set well. You don't need to go over here and turn it up and down. You can just turn it off. And remember how you do that? You press the button on the bottom, hold it. When it's off, you let it go. So we've seen how to use the mic, how to turn it on, how to turn it off. Next, how do you play a CD?
First thing is you press the open close button here. Tray comes out. You put the CD in and you press the button again to close it. And then you press play. You control the volume for the CD right here. You can hear it's turning on. And then usually you want to turn on repeat. It shows repeat right here. If you hit it again, it's repeat one, but that's usually not what you want. So you want it on repeat. This single play would play one song, which is kind of a DJ feature. Usually you just use the regular play. And now you could talk over this by turning this up and using the mic, or you could turn this down a bit, turn the mic up, talk over it. Or if you want, you can just fade it all the way out and use the mic, or just hit stop.
So let's say we have an iPhone or an iPad, an MP3 player, whatever, and we want to, you know, say anything with an eighth inch headphone jack, and we want to play it through the system. We use the auxiliary cable for that.
So you can see we have the auxiliary cable here attached to this iPad. And we'll turn on the video here. So it's got YouTube playing. And then we control the volume down here with aux, the last one. Up and down. And that's it.
So thanks for watching the video. I hope this helps. If you don't have access to the video, remember there's always the instructions here in the drawer. And you can always call me if you have more questions, and I can make another video maybe.